here, TalkFCB, and welcome back here to the channel, guys. A video here ahead of the new season, and in today's video, we are going to be looking at 8 different Barcelona players who have a point to prove. This season, it really, really matters, and these 8 guys, they've got to go out there and prove themselves. They really, really have, and in today's video, we are going to be discussing them in some detail. Let's get started. Let's do this. Because quite frankly, guys, although I've got 8 players mentioned in this particular video, I could say this for every single Barcelona player, because every single player next season should go out there with a point to prove in their mind. They should be going into this new season with a clear objective, a clear aim in their mind to what they want to achieve this season, and they should be going out every single game and giving it their all, proving their worth, proving why they should stay in the team. But in particular, these 8 players, they just sprang out to me. These 8 in particular, they really need to show that. They really need to prove to us they deserve this chance at Barcelona, and in particular, why they deserve their spot in the team. It's all coming up. This is massive. This season, we have to see ultimate effort. So starting right here with Nelson Semedo, the right back there at Barcelona. For me, it's a massive season for Nelson Semedo, and it's simply because Sergio Roberto is going to be moved to midfield. According to Ernesto Valverde, this season, Roberto is only going to play in midfield. That leaves for me a colossal chance for Semedo at right back. This is the season now to announce yourself, to really prove that you can be the out-and-out right back that Barcelona need week in, week out. You're in the team. There's no instability. You're not there 1 minute, then you're out the next. This is a massive chance for Semedo to go out there and really show, I can be that man. Because if he doesn't perform this season, if he doesn't actually show that he can be that right back, this could be the last season we see him in a Barcelona shirt. He's got to take this chance. He has to take this chance. For me, the one thing that he has to really focus on is going forward. His work in the final third, it's got to improve. He's got to be more productive there in the final third and be more adventurous, be more bold. But I think all of that could come with confidence. And this season, he should have confidence. He should have the faith of Valverde. And it's a massive season there for Nelson Semedo. Up next is Samuel Umtiti. And you all know where I'm going with this. This right here is a top quality centre-back when he's fully fit on his day. For me, Samuel Umtiti, arguably one of the best defenders, if not the best centre-back in the world. He really is that good with the ball at his feet, with defending in one-on-one situations, in the air, strong. He is absolutely terrific when he's fully fit. But that is the question. Was it the right call from him? He made it himself not to have that major surgery on his knee. Is he going to be able to this season to play the entire campaign injury-free? That's the big thing with Umtiti. Can he prove this season that he can be dependable? Can he be in the team week in, week out with no injury concerns? If he can, we could see here a massive, it could almost be like a new signing at centre-back if he can stay injury-free, because he can be that good. And of course, he's got to win his place back. Clement Longley last season came in, brand new signing. He stepped in for Umtiti. He did very, very well. This season, Umtiti's got to go out there and win that place back from his French compatriot, Clement Longley. He really has to do that. And you're also, of course, thinking about the French national team. If this season, Umtiti can't win that place back, if he doesn't dislodge Longley at centre-half, certainly in his country as well, he could be down the pecking order as Longley continues to rise. So Umtiti, he's got to get back in, he's got to keep himself fit, and ultimately, show his worth. Then there's Jordi Alba. And believe me, this is a big one. Because last season, for the majority of the season, he was absolutely terrific. He really was. Going forward last season, he had his best ever season in a Barcelona shirt. He was brilliant down the left-hand side. He was making incredible runs. He was really showing energy down that left-hand side. And also, combining there with Messi so, so well. He had so many assists to his name. He was even scoring a few goals too. But towards the end of that season, it was a long, hard season there for Jordi Alba. At the end of the season, he was a disaster. At Anfield, he made so, so many mistakes, a catalogue of errors there as we went out of the Champions League. And of course, in the Copa del Rey final, he really wasn't good either, as we lost that game and went out of yet another competition. So this season, it's really important for Alba to show the full quality of the player he is. That's not only going forward, that's not only doing your work in the final third, which is very, very important, but also focusing as well on those defensive duties. First and foremost, you are a defender, you've got to be good defensively, you can't be letting in silly goals, you can't be making silly mistakes. And I think this season, it's really important, of course, that we bring somebody in to give Alba that rest. Last season, he was stretched to his maximum. He wasn't also given any competition. This season, Alba will know, yes, he'll get rest, but also, when he's in the team, he's got to work hard to stay there. If we can bring somebody in there at that left-back area to challenge challenge him, I think it'll be better for the whole team and could also bring out the best in Jordi Alba, which, as we know, Jordi Alba at his absolute best is a wonderful, wonderful left back. That's what we've got to see on a consistent basis. Then there's Sergio Busquets, another massive Barcelona player over the years. He has been so consistent, so good in that midfield position, but right now he has come into some serious criticism, and especially at Anfield once again. He was overrun in that midfield, he was certainly struggling there to get to grips with that pressing from Liverpool, and it was difficult for him. He's 31 years old now. People seem to think that Sergio Busquets is finished as a footballer. I would actually disagree with that. I don't think that he's finished. I certainly do not think that Busquets doesn't have anything left to give. He can still give us something in this team. He can still be a top quality player, but also he's got to have the right system around him. He has to have the right players left and right. I think Frankie Young to the right, Arthur to the left. That will help certainly Sergio Busquets there unlock his best potential, because I think certainly we've got control of a game and we've got players in that midfield who will give him the right options, who won't put him in bad positions. I think Busquets in that holding role can still play a big part. He's still only 31 in a player there who's never been blessed with pace. It's not like overnight Busquets has suddenly lost his pace and now he's getting overrun. He's never been quick. He never ever has been, but he has always been extremely intelligent. And I think certainly given the players are in and given the system, Valverde has to get that right. But if he does, Busquets for me in that midfield can still play a part. He can still find his best level. And then of course there's Ivan Rakitic, who much like Busquets is another man here in the Barcelona midfield who's come in for some serious criticism over the past season or so. Rakitic has really been under fire, and much like Busquets, he's also 31 years old, which I think there actually is quite interesting, because you don't usually think of Rakitic and Sergio Busquets being the same age, but they are. They're at the same stage of their career, and this season I feel there's actually even more pressure on Rakitic than there is Busquets, because for me Rakitic has been coming out in the media. Barcelona offered him a route out, they would have sold him this summer, they would have moved him on, but Rakitic has come out and said no, I want to stay because I should be in this team. He fully believes that he still has the quality there to be in the team under Valverde week in, week out, and that's what he expects. And what I would say to that is, go out there then and prove that. This season, Rakitic shouldn't be in the team by default. If he earns his place, if he shows that quality week in, week out, of course play him. If he shows his quality, he should be in the team. But if he doesn't, if he isn't arriving in the big moments, if he's doing too much back passing, if he's not there being pressure resistant in the big moments, if he can't deal with the big games that we're going to be coming up against, Rakitic should be out of the team. And that goes for anybody. If you can't deal with it, if you're not good enough there to be in the team, get out. It's as simple as that. If you believe you should be there, you have to earn your place. No question about that. And then we move on to Felipe Coutinho, a man, of course, whose future at Barcelona is still very much uncertain. And if he does actually stay at Barcelona this summer, it's not exactly because the club have thrown all their weight behind it and said, look, we have full faith in Coutinho. We want him to stay. We're confident here that he can bring his best game. It'll be more because we haven't really received an offer that we deem enough to actually let him go. So he's only going to be staying, really, if nobody comes in for him. And that, for me, is the big, big problem. Because quite clearly with Coutinho, for me, you feel like it's all about confidence, all about his game here. It's all surrounding that feeling that he has inside of him, because he's not a bad player. He is not a bad footballer. But last season, for a lot of the games, you could easily make that mistake. And quite clearly so far, in his Barcelona career, he doesn't feel valued. He doesn't think he has an actual role in the team. He doesn't feel as though he has a place here. And I have to say, he's absolutely right. We have not treated Coutinho in the way that we should have for a signing there that cost us so much money. This right here is our record ever signing. And what have we done with him? Where have we put him in this team? What sort of confidence have we actually given him from what we've been doing with him? For me, it's just like Malcolm. It's just like Malcolm, whereby we've paid a big, big transfer fee here for a good player with good qualities, good characteristics, but we've had no actual plan as to where they'll fit in. We signed Malcolm, we signed Coutinho, and we got them in our squad. But now you're thinking, okay, now we've signed them, where are they going to go? Because quite clearly with Coutinho, he doesn't fit in the forward line. He doesn't really fit in midfield. But I think for me, he's closer there to that midfield role that he is a left winger. And unlike Malcolm, we've not had a good offer. We've not had a suitable offer for Coutinho where we could say, you know what, let's cut our losses. Let's actually make a bit of profit. Let's move him on. With Coutinho, we haven't had that option. And right now, we're just putting him somewhere to put him somewhere in that team. And that's not how you get the best out of your players. That's not they're going to get the best out of Coutinho. And for me this season, he must be in midfield. If you're going to give Coutinho an option here to have a long-term future at Barcelona, the only position that he can adapt to is midfield. That's the closest there that you can get. I still don't feel like he's tailor-made for that midfield, but that's a lot closer there than on the left-hand side. Because in the forward line, stuck out there on the wing, he's not quick. It's never, ever going to work there as a left midfielder. And I just think Coutinho again this season, you've got to see him in midfield. If we play him on the wing again, if we play him in that forward line, all we're going to see is an exact repeat of last season. He's still going to have no confidence, he's still not going to make an impact, and still, he's not going to really realise the potential at Barcelona. He's got to change this season, we've got to change, and for that reason, we have to see something different with Felipe Coutinho. And much like Felipe Coutinho, another big money signing in Ousmane Dembele has much to prove this season, because instead of poor form, instead of being played at a position, Dembele's biggest enemy is by far his very own injury concerns. Having missed a huge number of games throughout his first two seasons with injury problems, there was a number of different things that he's had go wrong, and right now, what he needs is a clean break. A season here where he stays completely injury free, where he can really get his head down and work hard, he looks happy, he looks motivated, he looks a lot more comfortable now, especially with the arrival of Antoine Griezmann there, somebody who's a bit older, a bit more mature. He can almost be a guidance there for Dembele, and that for me is exactly what he needed. Because last season, of course, yes, it was injury ravaged. Once again, Dembele wasn't able to show that full potential, but what we have seen right throughout his career so far at Barcelona is glimpses. We've seen glimpses there of the quality that he does have, often in very big moments. He does score big goals, he does provide big match-winning assists, but at the same time, this season, glimpses, it's not enough. We want to see from Dembele a consistent run of games with consistent performances to go with that, because we need to see all of that potential turn into permanent quality. We need this man this season to step up, to arrive, to be fit, to play many games, to be in the team consistently. That's down to Valverde there. Put him in the team. Let him go out there and show his quality, and all we can do is sit back and hope that the real Ousmane Dembele, with all of that potential, he can realise it this season. And last but not least, the eighth player on the list today, you probably guessed it was coming, it is Luis Suarez. A man here with a massive point to prove this season, because let's be honest here, Suarez last season and the season before that, his goal return is very, very good. But at the same time, that right now is not the major problem with Luis Suarez. The problem for me and the problem for all of us has been, we're seeing a player here who has been in a bit of a decline. Over the last season or so, game by game by game, you're just seeing Suarez deteriorate, whereby his overall game has been slipping, he's not had the quality, his first touch has been poor, and also his physical condition is becoming questionable too. And above all else, it's the Champions League. That's where it really comes down to it, when we've needed the goals in the big moments, and they just haven't been forthcoming for Luis Suarez. But now, of course, it's all changed. Suddenly, we've signed Antoine Griezmann. Suddenly now, Suarez, for the very first time in his Barcelona career there, as a centre forward, he has a serious, serious threat to that position. And Suarez knows now, he's got to find his best level. He has to find his best level, his best physical condition, to actually compete out and out there in that forward line with Antoine Griezmann. Because Griezmann, oh, he's going to be ready. He's going to be ready for a fight. And Suarez is going to need to match him at least. And he is to hoping this season that that signing of Griezmann there can be the shot in the arm for Luis Suarez. He's going to sit up and think now, I need to step up. I need to arrive. The time for getting myself in shape. I have to do it now. I've got to really up my game, raise my level to stay in this team. And if he does that, that'll be great. That'll be great, having Griezmann, who's such top quality, and also a motivated Suarez, a physically good Suarez. That is what you want in your team and your squad. Certainly, as many options as we can get, as many players in our team here fighting every single week to produce their best, that there is a match-winning team and a team that's capable of anything. So please leave your thoughts in the comments down below, guys. What did you think here of the eight names that I've mentioned, with players there that need to go out next season and really prove themselves? I'm just excited for next season. I'm excited here to see this group of players go out there and actually do it. I believe they can perform. I believe here they can find it within themselves to raise that level. And we should see this season a very good team going out there, challenging for all. But of course, big, big work to do, and the preseason will be continuing shortly. All of that and some more, it's going to be coming up. Thank you as always for watching, guys. I will see you soon indeed. Leave those thoughts down below. But until next time, as always, Visca! El Barça!